It's your girl Bobby J here, and we are talking about the Haves and the Have Nots Final Cast Reunion Part 1. That's right, and it was held where? In Atlanta, Georgia, in the legendary Tyler Perry Studios. That's right. And who hosted it? Who hosts all the reunion shows? Our girl Egypt Sherrod. That's right. Egypt is making her money, honey. Because she hosts all these things. There's too many shows out there. Reality, drama, comedy, dramedies, whatever. And she's hosting everything. So, shout out to Egypt. I'm like, okay. So, the cast all came out. Everybody was doing their thing. Walking. Hannah came with the cane and stuff. Making her way down. I was like, she was working her outfit. And the shoes on her and Veronica, they was slamming the shoes they had on. I tell you. But I think David is the only one. David and Jeffrey, they came down like, I don't know. They wasn't excited to watch them walk in. Not to mention Jeffrey came in all black, so he just looked blah. I mean, show us something about you. Show us your style. Come on, come with it. It's the reunion show. Everybody was working it. And it's amazing how different some of them look from their characters. You know what I mean? It's like a different something. Even Catherine. I'm not going to call them by their real names. I have to call them by their TV show names. Catherine got that daggone southern accent, was throwing me off. But anyway, before we get started with this whole cast reunion thing, if you have not subscribed to Barbie J's channel, please do that right now. Take a moment, hit the subscribe button. And if you wish, you can hit the notification bell and it'll let you know every time Barbie J uploads a new video. That's right. So always remember, like, comment, share, subscribe. Like, comment, share, subscribe. Like, comment, share, subscribe. Anyway, so who was in the house? Candace was in the house. Hannah was in the house. Benny was in the house. Veronica was in the house. Catherine was in the house. David was in the house. Wyatt was in the house. And Jeffrey was in the house. Who was missing? Jim. Jim was missing. Why was John Schneider missing? Because he was unable to make it. And as Egypt put it, that's because Hannah killed him. She killed him good. Still killed him. I ran his butt over. That's right. So anyway, I thought it was a real good, like I said, episode, part one reunion. And part two looked like it's going to be full of tears and everybody saying goodbye. And I'm not sure I'm ready for that and be able to take it next week. But I enjoyed this week. And I just even watched it twice. It was really wonderful. But let's see. They had a message from Oprah. Did they have a message from Tyler? But I know there was a message from Oprah. And she's like, Tyler Perry wanted to bring a prime time. She said, when Tyler Perry came to me and wanted to bring a prime time scripted dramedy or something like that to own. She was like, what? And she was like, he's writing all these shows. How does he do it? And she said, does this man sleep? How does he come up with all of these storylines? And she was saying that first storyline when Hannah came in and met Jim and she was the prostitute or lady of the night or whatever and stuff. And she had to open the jacket and had to, Oprah was coming in. Oprah gave her favorite part of each one of their scenes. Each one of their, her favorite scene of each one of their characters. That's what she did. So they had her come on and off throughout the whole show. But she said she wanted to thank the cast and its the viewers and all the people behind the scenes at the Have and Have Nots, because she said they will go down in history as the number one unforgettable show on OWN. It's possible. So I like that. I'm glad Oprah came on and gave her feelings, you know. And she told her favorite scenes and that was it. I'm just going to tell you a little bit. There was Tika who spoke about her encounter. She said, how that line, that one of the last scenes she had that was so touching was her last scene with Hannah, who's her mother on the show. And she said it was so emotional for her to say that because this is her first time apologizing and to her mother ever, and their bonding or something. It was like a bond going on. She said she forgot her lines. The tears was flowing. She forgot her lines, and Tyler had to bring her back out of it, you know, because she felt that part. She felt it. And would it be in the end, you know? So that was cool. She told about her encounter with Justin, who is now her real life husband. What's his name? James John or John James or something like that. It was never. But that's her real life husband. I mean, fiance. And they have a baby together. She had, I think she had it last year or the year before last. And they had an audience member ask how her husband, her fiance, felt with her love scenes. And he was basically, you know, it's a job, you know, you got to do it. And the truth is, like she said, I was doing this job before he came on the scene. His character wasn't there. I was there about whatever, 3-4 years before his character came in. So he was like, he was cool with it. He's like, I bet he was like, make your money, honey, you know. So what else? Crystal spoke about her nerves during the different love scenes. Crystal, Hannah talked about her love scene. I guess that was with, what's his name, Derek or whatever. So she had that one love scene, but she was like, her nerves during it. She said, here I am with all these pros over here. And it sounds so funny because she's calling them pros. And I went, my mind went, okay, I know she mean pros. Like they have more love scenes than her, but it just sounded like prostitute hooker pros, you know. But you know I'm crazy. Y'all know I'm crazy, so it is what it is. But I want y'all to let me know how y'all felt about it also down in the comment section. Don't forget to do that. So she talked about that, and you know, they have no problems, but it was like her nerves, you know, with her. So anyway, but she was looking good. All of them looked good when they came down. Let me see. Tika was working that red, Hannah was working that white, Benny was working all his black or whatever he had on, but it was nicely put together. I don't think it was all black. Veronica was stylish as always, you know. Catherine was looking good too. Wyatt was slamming. Jeffrey and David were, David looked nice. He had on a suit, that's right. He had on the suit and everything, but he would look okay. So I forgot to say that part because that was interesting. But like I said, let me go back to the shoes that were on Hannah and Veronica were slamming. But y'all go back and watch it. I was like, they had on the same style, but it was different. And they both were cute. Anyway, so Angela, Veronica mentioned her scene with Benny and how she had a, you know, she, oh wait. Let me go back to Candace was concerned about her character, thinking that people were going to hate her because of that character she played. And she said she didn't like when people was like, I want to be just like you when I get older. She's like, no. You don't want to do that. You don't want to do that. You know, she was like that scared her. But that was also one thing that she, you know, she was saying, how she didn't want people, she had that big concern about how people felt about her, because you see how people get into these shows and they like, I can't stand that bitch, it ain't that serious, it's a show. What is it, Angela, she mentioned her scene with Benny and how she was afraid, how she thought he might be feeling like he kissing his mama, and she was like, the little youngin over here and stuff, little baby over here, he said, no baby over here, I know what you talking about, you know. So they seemed like such a family, and it was so cool, and they were so nice, everybody was so warm, and I was like, is it really like that? But I gotta tell you, and was it Catherine said she flew all the way to where was it? Italy? For Wyatt's wedding. His real life wedding. But she said, but those scenes when she was about to play his mama and he took off his shirt, she was like, damn! She said, I couldn't, She said, I'm trying to focus and be his mama. She said, because honey, I'm single, so I'm trying to figure this out, you know? I'm trying to get it right. So I thought that was cute. But she said how Benny would always check on her after each, Veronica said, after the scenes and stuff, and he was so gracious and always asked if she was okay, you know, after the scenes. And she was like, yeah, stuff, you know. But she thought it was really sweet. And then Tyler, Lord help me. Benny mentioned that he, he mentioned the Houdini? Did y'all hear that part about the Houdini? He said they were really nude. They were wearing this something underneath. They put their junk in it, and that was it. So they basically was nude, but they had the Houdini that was supposed to be hiding their junk. I was like, stop playing. So Egypt was saying she thought they was really nude. Oh no, had on this bodysuit that went all the way up and stuff. Which I thought, I think back in the day they did stuff like that. But he said that's not what it was. I was like, okay. All right. So that was funny. And there was a lot of laughing and love. And I was enjoying this. And so, like I said, Catherine said she was single. And they were saying which one of the scenes did she like. She said, the love scene, she said, ooh, it depends on who the person was. She was like, because if it was Roderick, she showed a scene with Roderick and her. That boy had a body and a half and a half and a half. Ooh. So, and she said, I told y'all about the scene with Wyatt. He was coming down the steps or something like that. And here she is. Wyatt, what are you doing? Trying to talk to him. And there was another scene when he took off all his clothes. See, I told you, man, I don't have nothing. And Catherine and Veronica were standing there. And Jeffrey was standing there too. And Wyatt took off all his clothes, saying he don't have nothing, and walked away. Supposed to be naked. I was like, oh, snap. I think I remember that scene too. What else happened? They were doing a lot of funny scenes and laughing. They had a lot of what are they called? Fans who were asking questions. They had this one fan who was a super fan, and she would have and have not parties and liquor with their names on it. And she had a Candace and a Benny, Mr. Potato Head or something like that. And what else? She also had some other stuff. The liquor, the gift bags that spelled out the letters on it, have and have not. And so, who else? Then they talked to Wyatt. Wyatt was upset. He said he never got a love scene. He's still waiting for Tyler after 7 years to write him a love scene. He said he did all that work getting in shape and everything, trying to look good, no carbs for about 6 months. He was like, what happened? You know, and the fan asked him how did he feel to tell off his parents or something like that. And he gave his opinion, the Wyatt answer and the Aaron answer with that. Benny, this was his first acting gig. Everybody was clapping and stuff. And you know, he was happy that he got to they asked him what did he do when he got it. When he got the call saying he got it, he was like, yo, I got some Henny. It was like, yo, we gonna be this and this. He was doing all of that. I was like, oh no, and everybody's laughing. He was like, yo, we about to roll up and blah, 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 blah. I'm about to this and that. I said, I can hear you now. I believe he did that too. But he said playing the role of a black man trying to support his family and do the right thing was a treat for him to play. And he thanked Tyler Perry for that. And I can appreciate that, you know, especially a mother, and I have a son as well. You know, so you know that feeling. You want them to be there for you. So Benny, he surprised that super fan I was telling you about. He surprised them. She had the people, they thought they was going to talk to the producers, and he was on it. And when he finished talking to her and they were logging on, she said, oh, he's so fine. He's so fine. That girl was like, oh. And then they gave her tickets to bring her and a friend to the show, and she was in the audience. So that was really nice. And what was one of the last things? The scene with, oh, David was talking about the scene with killing Veronica, and he wasn't sure about wanting to do that. But then that was that scene when she was saying, he's not your child, he's not your child, or something like that. And he was like, okay, I could do this. He was like, drowning her and stuff. He was like, I could do this scene. And then they said they all thought it was the end of Veronica when that character died, because they didn't see the script for the next week. And they all in there saying, oh, and they crying and stuff. And Tyler's like, what the freak is going on? Tyler Perry's, what's going on? They like, you know, they cry. He said, I'll tell y'all when to cry. Like, Veronica ain't going nowhere. But David said, I tried to kill her, but them lifeguard lungs brought her back. And who is Catherine. Catherine, I love her voice. She had this southern voice. She was really nice. And there was a little bit of Catherine crying, and she said in her, you know, she said there's a lot of these characters in women. She said none of us women want a cheating man and get angry about it, and we don't want to be gaining weight and have him bring it up to our attention and all that stuff. So that was wonderful. Wyatt, Wyatt didn't say much. Wyatt seemed to be pretty much quiet. I don't know what scenes really moved him. It's for some reason I didn't write anything down about Wyatt, and that's weird. I know he had on a black and was sitting laid back, but they showed his different. Oh, they did. I'm sorry. Wyatt was the one who that girl told him that she came out of the closet and told had to tell her parents, and she appreciated his character coming out in the way he had to do and tell them and stuff. That script and how it helped so many other people to do that. And he got up and went over there and hugged her, just like Benny got up and hugged that super fan, you know. And there was somebody else who got up and hugged somebody. Three of them, I think, got up and hugged. And it was most the men, I believe. But it was really a nice reunion. I can't wait to hear for see next week, because it seemed like it's going to be emotional. They're going to say goodbye to each other. And you know, I hope y'all enjoy it like I did. This is your girl. Oh, don't forget to write it down in the comment section. And don't forget, like, comment, share, subscribe. Peace.